that's when it's really dear to your heart because you're scared to disappoint.
There he is, folks. Tyquan Cole making his way down to the K4 cage. His back of his shirt says, "You can't teach heart." Have truer words ever been spoken on the way to the cage?
That is not true. You either have it or you don't. You can teach grit, but you can't teach heart.
Exactly, as the back of the shirt say there.
He looks good too, man. I seen him warming up in the back. Like, he looks like very athletic, moves really well. We'll see how it plays out once he gets in there with some real adversity against him.
And we saw the synthesis team earlier as we had Jaden Peters get finished by Thomas Trexler.
That was a short notice fight, though. That doesn't really show how good Synthesis is. They're very good not really local, but they're a very good gym. They come here quite a bit.
Very
their
talented.
Athletes are usually very well-rounded and very good at jiu-jitsu.
Well, we saw a couple of them back in October at a kickboxing event we worked together, I believe.
Yes, sir.
Was that where, what's his name? Judas from? Julius Jackson?
I'm not sure where he's actually from.
I thought he was out of that gym for a second. Forgive me, folks, if I'm wrong with this most people. Synthesis BJJ team on deck, ready to make that walk to the cage. Jan Sheenan going down the steps. Got the family screening off to his left.
He's another guy who looks just like a fighter.
Oh, yeah.
Got that super jock face. Muscles everywhere. Someday I'm going to grow a muscle, right?
And his coaches look like they're tough guys, too.
They got that old weathered look. They're definitely tough.
Main coach, that grease in the face, looks like a guy that can throw down some serious barbecue on the grill.
And then punch six people in the face while he's cooking them.
Cook some awesome ribs and beat up the entire barbecue at the same time.
That's for sure.
Tyquan Cole's in there, getting checked over by the ref, looking cool as a cucumber, man. It doesn't really get better than that if you're looking for a relaxed mental state before getting into some sanctioned violence.
Once again, we're going to be doing some amateur rules. You can tell by the shin guard. Anytime you see a fighter with shin guards in MMA, it means they come out round and pound to the head on the ground, and no knees to the head, as well as no elbows at all. Touch gloves, smiles on the face, they're ready to go.
Tyquan Cole's in the red. His opponent, Jack Shields, will go in the black.
Good time by Tyquan.
Tyquan is definitely a good athlete.
He looks really sharp and slick. He got that hand kind of turned to keep his opponent guessing.
Tyquan is a good athlete.
Oh, nice.
Good sprawl.
That was quick. Point those hips right to the ground. Perfect technique.
Sheena had an excellent shot, too. He's just a little bit too far away.
Now they're swinging.
He hit a grounded opponent. The referee's stopping it. You cannot hit him when his knees are on the ground. He might take a point.
It seems like the people here in front think the fight is over. That is not the case.
No, they're just moving away. Because I didn't think he hit him down.
He was on his knees. You can't go forward and hit him when he's got one knee on the ground.
At least not to the head.
Not to the head, yeah. You can go to the body, just not to the head. And he clearly landed a strike to the head. But it's hard to not, you train to do that.
Yeah.
And then, like, after your two fights, you're going to hit him in the head there. So, like,
It looks like he's trying to show off that right hand there, Taekwon Cole. He keeps rotating it, circling around there, kind of showing off with it. I don't know if that's maybe kind of selling the store or what. But,
oh, he just ate a big one, and then unfazed. Oh, another big one.
That one snapped Cole's head back.
Very elusive. Cole's already starting to breathe a little bit heavy. I get nervous when you see these super athlete guys and they have the bad technique of keeping their hands down.
They're going to skirt right around to the back.
Nice.
He does, taking the choke. Not quite under the chin yet. Might have to re-wrap, readjust, and can get it from here.
Taekwon Cole is doing a great job hand fighting down there.
Yep.
He's not letting him
Taekwon
do his hand around.
Not Taekwondo.
Cole, yeah, not Taekwondo. There we go. Now it's underneath the chin.
He needs to fight the hands. Instead, he taps out. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Your hometown boy, Jeff Sheehan, gets the rear naked choke in round number one.
Man. What a comeback. That was great.
Really good fight. Down, let's flip to the back.
Excellent grab, man. Those seat pieces guys got really good jiu-jitsu.
And that's after getting dropped there, too.
That gets the back.
Man, he had him fully extended there, too.
Oh, yeah.
You saw he was trying to elbow the knees or the shin. Anything, excuse me, the thighs, excuse the correct terminology here. MMA fights on deck before we finish out with some Muay Thai fights.
Your winner by the rear naked choke at 2 minutes and 1 second into round number one at the Green Leaf Red Corner, Jeff Sheehan.
Fight girls. Great performance, man. Stayed composed through the eyes of the flyer there. Was able to take it back after getting that takedown.
Somebody to take a picture for that?
Caveman doesn't use that technology. Speaking of the caveman, let's send it up to him for another post-fight interview.
I'm here with the winner, Jeff Sheehan.
Trying to get you a big pop. But here you go.